The Commission on Elections commits to resolve all pending petitions against the presidential bid of Ferdinand Marcos Jr. next month. A total of 7 petitions were filed against the candidacy of Marcos. 6 have been junked by different COMELEC divisions, and several motions for reconsideration are pending before the OMBEC. Only the disqualification case filed by Pudno Nga Ilocano remains pending before a COMELEC division.
The decision on these cases, the consolidated cases, and as well as the case with the motion for reconsideration, will be decided before the election, but earlier, even before the end of April. Maybe the earliest will be the second week of April, the latest will be the third week of April.
The poll body also asserts it has not fallen victim to any attacks amounting to a security breach, but the COMELEC says it will not take the allegations lightly as it orders a review of its contract with Smartmatic. President Rodrigo Duterte's political advisor urges him to endorse Ferdinand Marcos Jr. as the next president. His reason? So the chief executive would be protected from possible legal actions when he steps down from office. Jacinto Paras also believes a Marcos win will help Duterte in facing the International Criminal Court, which may continue its suspended investigation on the government's bloody war on drugs.
Well, I feel that Bongbong Marcos is the right candidate to endorse the president. First, I feel that loyalty and friendship is very important between two people. The president, in real politics, has one way or another has done favors to the Marcos family. He would be prevented from being harassed by people who will file Trump up charges.
Tinitingnan mo lang yung beneficyo sa'yo personally.
Because he has a choice. And that choice is just one of the many other reasons why he should support Bongbong Marcos.
Meanwhile, the chairman of Aksyon Demokratiko, the party of presidential candidate Francisco Isko Moreno Domagoso, wants Duterte to go after Marcos. He wants the president to order the Bureau of Internal Revenue to collect the Marcos family's unpaid estate taxes worth 203 billion pesos, or over $3.8 billion.
Sayang yan, nakapagpatayo sana ng mga ospital yan, nakapagpatayo sana ng mga paaralan yan. Marami, no? Kasi naman umutang tayo ng umutang. Di na natin alam nga kung saan tayo pupunta ng pondo. Ang daming krisis ngayon tayong kinakaharap.
The possible poll victory of candidates coming from big business families raises conflict of interest issues. That's according to some political analysts. Data from the Nielsen and Intel had shown senatorial candidates Mark Villar and Senators Sherwin Gatchalian and Joel Villanueva are the top spenders of advertising on traditional media. The senatorial aspirants aired ads worth more than 1 billion pesos. That's from January 2021 to January 2022. That's even before the campaign period began.
The RA6713 is stating is that to avoid conflict of interest, the candidates and later on, if they become members of the Senate and the House of Representatives, they have to actually resign from the board of trustees of the companies that their family owns. At the same time, also, they should not use their position, particularly if they become chairs of committees that decide on certain issues in the Senate or in the House of Representatives. They should not use their influence to actually protect their interests.
The camp of Vice President Lenny Robredo denouncing NTFL-CAC spokesperson Lorraine Badoy's red-tagging. Teddy Bagila Jr., who is part of Robredo's senatorial ticket, suspects Badoy is targeting Robredo because her presidential campaign is growing stronger. The former Ifugao congressman also says he will push for the abolition of the controversial anti-communist task force if he wins in the May polls.
The whole point of our program is let's focus on developing the countryside, the impoverished places, ancestral domains. Kasi nga, statistics would show that marami sa mga pumapasok sa rebelda, sabi daw nila, are katutubo because of what they're experiencing within their ancestral domains. So yun yung ating tugunan. We may still have the same budget not under NTF-LCAC, but let's give it to the Department of Agriculture, the National Commission for Indigenous Peoples, DepEd, bigyan ng edukasyon, no, yung mga vulnerable groups to extremism,